the American Heart Association, and you're going to be doing all sorts of healthy things this year here at school and at home with your parents and your brothers and sisters. So you are a very, very lucky group of students, because the people sitting here are the ones supporting you. They're giving money. Who knows what money is?
Yeah.
All right. Okay, put your hands down. So they're giving a lot. I'm not going to tell you the amount because it would like blow your mind, and it's too early in the morning for that to happen. But it's a lot of money that they're investing in you, because they love Gosler Park and they love the Leader in Me program, and they just love what you people do as leaders here in the school. So I'm going to introduce my very good friend who has been responsible for paying and supporting the Leader in Me program for the last 5 years. 5 years he's been doing this. So let's give my friend a hand, and I'll tell you who he is in a minute. Okay. So my very good friend is the CEO of the Granny United Way, and those are the shirts you're wearing today. They also got all of these for us and for you today. So can you thank Patrick Tufts? All right, so I'm going to have my friend Mr. Tufts come on up and speak to you about what's going to be happening. Please give him your very best attention.
Thank you, Principal Upham. Again, my name is Patrick, guys, and I am so happy to be at Gosler Park School today and to thank you for being some of the youngest members of the Day of Caring. Some of you guys, this is your first time that you're going to go out and you're going to volunteer. Do people know what volunteer means? Volunteer means we take some of our time and we do something to make somebody else's life better. And that's what I love about Gosler Park School. All of you guys as students, all of your teachers, the administrators, your parents, Gosler Park School always thinks about our friends out in the community. So what you guys are doing today as part of the Day of Caring is you're going to volunteer your time to make somebody else's life better. And I got a few notes here on some of the neat things that you're going to do today that are going to make somebody else's life better. You're going to paint friendship rocks. You're going to create placemats for people who get Meals on Wheels delivered to their homes. You're going to do cards to thank ambulance drivers and police officers and firemen and women out in our community. And you're going to do cards to welcome the new Leader in Me schools here on the west side, because we are very, very happy to partner with Gosler Park School in the Manchester School District to copy Leader in Me at Gosler Park School and do it at all schools on the west side. So we are very, very happy to be able to do that. And we're able to do it because you guys at Gosler Park School have done such a great job. I just want to make sure that I thank Mrs. Stebbins. Sally Stebbins is here. Mrs. Stebbins and her husband Mark and all their friends at Procon have been very generous to the United Way so that we can help the students of Gosler Park School and all the students on the west side be awesome through Leader in Me. So thank you very much for volunteering today. Thank you very much for thinking about your friends in the community. And I just really, really appreciate everything you guys do. So I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Ledoux from Procon. Jimmy is going to say a few words on behalf of the company, and I hope to see all you guys running around doing volunteering many more times in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. You guys excited for the program? All right. Well, I hope my speech is good because Mrs. Stebbins is my boss, and I better do good. So, on behalf of Mark and Sally Stebbins, the owners of ProCon, who are supporting the Heart Healthy Challenge, and also the program you may recognize, The Leader in Me. You guys recognize that? All right. Well, this year it's going to be all in the West Side. So as you guys go up in grades, you'll know this program very well. But like Mark and Sally, we want you to be able to grow up and give back to your communities. No matter how you do that, either with time or with money, one thing's always important, that we remain healthy. This program will challenge you to become a healthier person by creating habits now that will positively affect your future. I want to thank Patrick and United Way, as well as one of my favorite schools, that's not a lie, in the entire district, Gosselin Park. All right. Always finding innovative ways and ideas to make learning fun, and this is one of them. So have fun, learn new things, but more importantly, take care of your own bodies by exercising and eating healthy. All right, thank you. So I want to introduce Christine Parent, who is going to show us a video.
Good morning, Gosselin Park. Well, I know there's a lot of energy in this room. I feel like you can maybe do a little bit better. Good morning, Gosselin Park.
Good morning!
Yes, that's what I like to hear. So again, my name is Christine Parent. I am so happy to be here this morning with the American Heart Association to talk with you a little bit about heart health. So I know some of you are saying, this is Parent Heart Health. That doesn't really sound like that much fun. But it is going to be fun, I promise. We're going to talk a lot about why taking care of your heart is so important. I have some videos of some fun little heart heroes that are going to talk to you about different things that you can do to take care of your hearts. And I also have a video of some fun, cute little animals that are going to share some different heart health facts with you. So the first thing that I want you all to do is I want you to make a fist. Hold it up in the air. So this is about the size of your heart that is beating in your chest right now. So while I talk with you a little bit about some different heart facts, I want you all to make pretend that your heart is beating by opening and closing your fist. Good, good. So your heart is located right here in the center of your chest. Keep them going. And a lot of people think that your heart is actually over to the left of your chest, but it actually is right there in the middle, and it's nestled in right between your two lungs. It is tilted a little bit to the left because your right lung is a little bit bigger than your left lung, and it just kind of pushes it over that way a little bit. And it's right behind this bone right here, and that helps keep it really safe. Now, it's important that your heart stays really safe from all of the crazy activities that you do to keep healthy, because your heart has a really important job, and your heart's really important job is to pump blood to all of the other organs in your body. So all of your other organs, like your brain and your lungs and your stomach, all need blood and oxygen to do their jobs the correct way. Now, I noticed that a lot of you, almost all of you, have stopped making your pretend hearts beating. How come? You're tired? Hey, listen, I only talked for maybe like a minute, maybe two, and you're already tired? Now, what do you think happens if your heart gets tired? You guys who kept doing it, thank you, can stop now. What happens when our heart gets tired? Well, I guess that's true, but does it get to take a rest? Does your heart get to say, well, I'm just going to take a quick little rest for a few minutes while I get some energy back up? No, right? So what about at night when you go to bed? Does your heart stop beating when you go to bed, when you go to sleep? No way. It can't stop beating, right? Because
It's not just a muscle. It's a very special organ. No, not that kind. Constantly pumping oxygen and nutrients to every part of your body. We're here to celebrate it, learn about it, and find out ways to keep it healthy. So let's get pumped! True or false? Laughing is good for your heart. That's true. Laughing reduces stress and helps boost your immune system.
So what do you think?
I told you heart health could be fun, right? My little animals helped make that true, yes? Good. So we talked a lot about the heart, and you learned a lot of new, interesting heart facts. So you know that the heart has a really important job. But now we're going to talk a little bit about the different things me do that, I have all of my heart heroes. You can kind of see them all up on the screen, and I have all of them here on my little clip. And what's really cool is that each month,